Last week, the US dollar ended the week mixed but net negative in a week filled with lots of Fed speak and historically bad US economic updates. But the talks of opening the economy back up had traders more risk-friendly as they dumped the US dollar towards the weekend. The British pound, on the other hand, was a big net loser, especially the beginning of the week, thanks to both no-deal Brexit fears and disastrous UK economic updates. Welcome to the Tickmill Update. I'm Kiana Danielle, the founder of the Invest Diva movement. Make sure to subscribe to the Tickmill YouTube channel and support us by liking and sharing this video with your Forex trading friends. This week, we'll be focusing on New Zealand's interest rate decision, as well as Australia's jobs report, among other key economic data and the coronavirus updates. Today, I'm looking at the Aussie yen pair on the long-term time frame, the monthly chart. The pair was able to pull itself back up from the lows of March in the past month and a half, and avoided dropping to the lows of 2008 and 2009 market crash period. This obviously had to do with a renewed optimism about the economy's opening back up during the COVID-19 pandemic. However, we need to keep in mind that countries opening up could also mean another surge in the COVID-19 cases and therefore yet another blow to the unemployment and the economy. With that, in my opinion, a revisit of the lows of 55 is still not out of the question. Do you think the coronavirus impact on the markets has ended for good? Head over to the comment section and let me know. Of course, trading in the financial markets involves a risk of loss, and you should only trade the money that you can afford to lose. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the Tickmill YouTube channel. I'll get back to you with more updates tomorrow.